All right, Chris McCusker joins us from 680 News to talk a little business and the Fed chair. Speaking of Jackson Hole.
Yes, this is an annual event.
Doing a little skiing.
Yeah, well, okay. We're hoping that there's going to be some sort of signal on interest rates from the Fed chair during the speech today in Jackson Hole. Market's really expecting to hear that there's going to be another interest rate cut in the U.S. in the next couple of weeks. We just saw a cut stateside in July, so that will be watched very, very closely. Price for oil not doing much so far this morning. It is looking at potentially a weekly gain. We did hear about a build in U.S. gas stockpiles this week as demand slows somewhat. And then, of course, the U.S.-China trade issues have also played a role in the price for oil. It did take a bit of a beating at the beginning of the month. It's recovered a little bit. And then we're going to get retail sales data in Canada in about 2 hours from now. Our loonie a tiny bit lower ahead of that. L.L. Bean is about to move into Canada. So the first store will open in Oakville in a couple of hours from now. This is a longtime U.S. retailer. It's got a 100-year history stateside. And the doors are set to open on this brick-and-mortar location in Oakville. You can also get the merchandise through HBC or at thebay.com, so it's not just exclusively to the Toronto area. L.L. Bean, as I say, has existed in the U.S. for more than 100 years, so Canadians until now have been able to order through the catalog or online. Stephen Smith is the president and CEO at L.L. Bean. He says the move into Canada has probably been decades in the making. He also says, given that they are headquartered in Maine, they're very familiar with Canadian weather and the fact that we like to be comfortable outside when it's cold. And Overstock.com is looking for a new CEO. The former one has been on a bit of a media blitz after leaving the retailer, which he led for about 20 years. Patrick Byrne has cited entanglements with the deep state, which included cooperation with law enforcement agents that he referred to as Men in Black. He was also romantically involved with a Russian operative who's now been jailed for failing to register as a foreign agent. Now, his resignation email was about 1,600 words, and in it, he vowed to disappear and then did at least two TV appearances last night in the U.S. So I guess more to come potentially on this. Yeah, the stock not doing much in pre-market trade. It saw a big bounce yesterday, though.
If you're going to flame out in style.
Yeah, a lot of drama.
Chris, have yourself a great weekend.
Yes, you too.